The greatness of life can be experienced through introspection. The celebration that we gain in exploring answers for all the quests we have in our minds would truly be great. We can lead a life of somebody through the information that was given to us by the people around. Or the greater way of living is through a quest within, with a big question, why, and exploring the reality, which would truly reveal to us the greatness of life. How fortunate we are being a human. Just think, what greatness can be created by life when we don't have an attitude that life is great? Realize that life is no ordinary gift. The body that is given to lead this life is no ordinary one. Using this body with life, there is a lot that we can do. If there is anything we can do, we need to do when we can cast a shadow of ours. What is there that we can do later? Just imagine, if we have dissatisfaction at the time of our death that we couldn't do much with our life, what a pain it would be. Think. This realization would make us do much beyond what we are thinking we can do today. And by exploring what we can do, life gets its celebration. Let me introduce you to one such celebration who loved the question why and who celebrated life by exploring answers for it. She is Sharada Dwivedi. Completing a specialization in commerce, she got into Indian Institute of Applied Economics and Research, but this job just lasted for 3 days as she couldn't celebrate statistics. Later, she got a job as an assistant librarian in an international school, and it was here in the library where her eyes opened to the world of books and the knowledge that was contained in it. Here, she collected enormous information, especially about culture, music, art, and heritage. Books became her world. Later, she did her graduation in library sciences with a specialization in reference work. Here, she learned the greatest lesson that she followed, that is, not to depend on secondary source when we can find a primary source of information. Completing her degree, she went to Paris and worked in an American library, and she also traveled all along Europe, widening her perspective greatly. Later, getting married, she moved into a flat full of books, musical instruments, and paintings. Her husband, being a history student, supported and encouraged her a lot. History gave a lot of answers to her questions of why. With vast and extensive knowledge in her hand, she started to write. She wrote her first book for Taj magazine, which gave her an opportunity to write about the history of Taj Hotel. Inspired by their work, that much of their income goes into service, she did it. Later, she authored a book along with Alan, Lives of the Indian Princes, interviewing many living people who knew about it. She helped BBC in creating documents on Indian history and the Maharajas of India. She even wrote a novel for children, The Broken Flute. She wrote many columns on city architecture, corporate history for Blue Star, not from the corporate angle, but through human side, through people who worked for the company. Later, The Cities Within, a book on the history of Mumbai, became a sensation. When she was asked, "Don't you have any problem writing books with other authors?" as she did many, she said, "In fact, there are a lot of advantages." Writing with professionals in other fields, it adds new dimensions and perspectives to work. Even as a child, she loved the monumental constructions. She had also set up Eminence Designs, a graphic designing and publishing house, contributing to the conservation of Indian art, heritage and culture. By printing quality books, she gave a lot of attention for each page, each photograph, its design and style. She always coordinated with photographers, authors, editors and designers to create wonderful works. She encouraged many to write books on their native places, and this idea gave birth to many books on Goa, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Pune, etc. through Eminence Designs. She was in the advisory committee of Urban Designs and Research Institute. She even took the US President Bill Clinton around Mumbai when he visited India. All her life, she extensively worked on the research and writing of many historical places and monuments in India, safeguarding it. Thank you. Every day, in every way, life is getting better and better. Don't miss to be a part of Venuskal Training Academy, as you can't miss life.